I'm Tom Bassett, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use the tooling API to manage sandboxes. I've already forked the Salesforce developers API collections into my own workspace and authenticated with my own Salesforce org. The first call I'm going to demonstrate is listing sandboxes. So let's get started by pressing on list sandboxes and then sending our request to Salesforce. When the request comes back, you can see that we don't currently have any sandboxes available. So let's start by creating a sandbox. So we're going to choose the create clone sandbox, and we're going to review the body before we send the request. I want to create a developer sandbox. I don't need a template ID, and I don't need to worry about history days, copy chatter for this type of sandbox either. I don't want to define an Apex class ID description. Source ID, because I'm not cloning a sandbox, and I'm going to leave auto activate as it is, and I'm going to send my request to Salesforce. You can see that the request has now been sent and it's returned back the sandbox ID.
So now that we've waited a while and the dev sandbox has been successfully completed, we can now use the tooling API to clone this sandbox using the create clone sandbox endpoint. I can adjust the body so that it includes the source ID of the sandbox I want to clone, the name for the cloned sandbox. You'll also notice that I've removed the sandbox type. When I press send, you can see that the sandbox clone has now been requested and Salesforce has returned to me the sandbox ID. Similarly, if I want to delete a sandbox, then I need to pass in the ID of the sandbox and then press send.
This hasn't worked in my demo environment because the sandbox I'm trying to delete has only just been created. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and add any feedback in the comments. Thanks.